We didn't know last time. I kind of knew that we would probably meet. You were going to go at it during the Bernie
right.
fight and shit, but I didn't know we were going to, you know, meet in the fucking arena with knives and long you are at the dumb fuck. It was great. Why can't you? You know, it reminds me of a quote that I can't fucking possibly attribute it, but it's like sometimes it's like someone who's like ideologically close to you is like worse if there's like that sort of disagreement. It's like, fuck, you're so close to just understanding the truth. Why? That's actually a really interesting thing that you said, because I couldn't find a way. I was doing an ideology recently in terms of when we're filming the show. It might be months old.
Who knows?
Yeah, I don't know when this is coming out, but I was filming ideology recently where people were asking about disagreements. I kind of tried to tell them about the disagreement we had in the first part of the show without spoiling any of it. I'm like, yeah, dude, we went at it. TJ went at it in the shows. But they were trying to like get into like, okay, well, why were you mad? They were digging for info on it. I wasn't giving that up. But I was trying to come up with a way to say what you just said.
Yeah.
Which is that when you have somebody like TJ and I and say what you want about it, like before we knew each other, we were ideologically pretty fucking close.
Right.
Not so much in his libertarian phase. I never had one of those. We were pretty opposed at that point, but I was pretty vocal. Vocally opposed to TJ during that phase of his shit. Nobody's watching me, but I was. And then after that, you know, TJ and I don't have a whole lot of distance politically. So when we agree on something that I think we both agree is important enough to have a firm position on,
yeah,
makes it 10 times worse than some moron walking by you and going, "Fuck you, we'll fight you," or whatever. You know, like,
yeah.
So anyway, that's neither here nor there, guys. You say you want a revolution, TJ. I've heard you say that many times. In fact, I've heard you call for violence.
Yeah. Say you want a revolution.
Yeah. I've heard you call for violence and immediate revolution, not only against our government, but against the entire world and all of their government.
And against McDonald's.
With McDonald's, TJ. That's the only flaw in your plan.
Wicked McDonald's.
Yeah. You golden arches on your side, the world will fall.
That might be true. Fucking Ronald's army, dude.
Yeah, it's totally apropos of nothing, but it kind of connects. I was watching for probably the third time or fourth time in my life, Mad Max Fury Road last night.
Hell yeah.
Amelia's first time seeing it, and her first introduction to the Mad Max franchise as a whole. She hasn't seen any of the old ones.
It's all downhill from there after that, though. And like, that one just cranked it to such a level that, like, I mean, and it's the first time I've ever watched a, like, think about the power of that movie, because I watched that movie, and I'm like, I never need to watch The Road Warrior again. Like, I could, yeah, but, like, I never need to again. Like, this just surpasses that effect.
Not bad. So, then here's something I learned about Mad Max, because something has changed in my viewing habits, and I mean, it turns out it's actually way more of a change than I think it is. I turn on every movie I watch and every show that I watch without fail subtitles.
Right.
Even if I can hear plain as day what's coming out of people's mouths, I want the transcription. I've trained myself to want that now.
Right.
I can do without it in the theater and shit. But here's the thing. I will watch, like I said, 3 or 4 times Mad Max Fury Road. But not since I became an old man and started turning on the subtitles. And reading the script of that movie, number one, it disabused me of a notion that I had about that movie that there's not a lot of dialogue. There is. I watched it 3 times, and I came out the other end going, like, one of my favorite things about that is, like, how no dialogue it is. Now, it's not, like, a total wordy movie. Right? There's a lot of dialogue in that movie.
There's more than you suspect.
I wasn't hearing what they were saying. Just in varying accents, screamed as cars fly overhead and shit. And one of the things I, anyway, to bring it back home, because we were talking about the Golden Arches, one of the things I noticed about the movie, and it's just a tiny little reference that's never brought up again, during one of those battles where the war boys are trying to take down the war rig, and one of them's about to die, his friend that's driving the truck goes, you know, you're awaited, you're awaited, you will McFeast in Valhalla. And I was like, McFeast? I never heard it, you know, because I would get the insult. That's such a loud scene, and it always got buried. And I'm like, how cool is that? It's like, like, so here in the universe, here's what we can extrapolate from that, right? In the universe, of course, after the fall, McDonald's was like local legend. People were alive that knew it. They were like, oh man, this McDonald's. And then that got passed down to their kids who never knew it. But like, mom used to tell me that McDonald's place, man. And then generation, and then it goes to shit. Generation, then the desert. Right? And by the time it gets to Mad Max Fury Road, it's like been woven into religion. Right? Well, the McFeast is actually the name of a burger in Australia, where the Mad Max movie comes. So I didn't even recognize that. This is the McFeast right here.
I guess in the bucket, it's not your apocalypse, dude. The McFeast is the name.
Cold outside. It's cold outside. Ah. Not fair. It's over. Yeah, the round is almost over.
Enemy forces!
No, kitty. Oh, shit, kitty. Oh, shit, kitty. What you up to, huh? You got a job interview to go to tomorrow, huh? You got a wedding? Got a friend's wedding? Kitty, like, fuck yeah, I got a wedding to go to. Oh, no, wedding to go to. Kitty got to go somewhere. Got places to be. Kitty got places.
Нужен транспорт. Эй, давай сюда.
Так точно.
Понял. Понял.
Fuck you! Really?
I didn't even realize it was that bad. I switched to help out.
Hello. I'm pressing the button. Could you hear me?
Yeah, I can hear you now.
Oh, I can't see the icon. It was weird.
There's a ton of motion mines.
He's our stop.
Go the back way.
Oh no, I'm just letting you know because I put some down. There's like 10 of them around the corner. This one's so hard to get. There's
a jeep right over here.
One more. Their walker's coming.
I got EMPs to annoy the shit out of it.
Get ready. I'm surprised he didn't switch over too, because he's the one that was.
Sorry, I didn't mean to make you wait long.
I'm going to
grab the jeep and go in the back if you want.
Okay, I'll try to get the walker while you do that. Make it my mission to take out that walker. Maybe. If I don't die.
Ready for that walker.
Yeah, I was trying to get that other flag, but there's so many infantry there.
Oh, yeah. Kind of rough.
It wasn't the right kit to deal with them all.
I'm really good with the nades. I don't know why.
Противник!
I'll try to get the walker.
Get me a box.
Hit robot.
Yeah.
Oh, never mind. I'm dead.
Okay.
I took the walker from the spot, but it was already damaged.
Замешаны силы противника. Внимание, противник! Здесь снайпер! Вот так! Мы в
подкрытии!
Подкрепление! Мощно! Противник! Точка захвачена! Точка захвачена! Medic needed!
Righto! Awesome! Thanks!
Is our walker still up?
No, it's down. It should be spawning any second. And I think it spawned in.
Yeah.
One on the roof.
Start off.
You didn't go to the doctor. You didn't work. You didn't have children. You didn't work. You didn't live. And like that's still kind of true. I'm not saying that ain't still true, but there are government programs in place that if you can't work.
Cheers. есть раненый. Frag out!
Oh, yeah.
enemy in sight.
Who's spamming me?
Enemy 40! Round 5.
soldier, you deserve an award.
Ah!
Engine is now active. Right, go!
Противник, здесь робот!
ходу противника. Внимание, робот!
much. Bots. Fucking bots, man. Fucking piss me off. Suck my dick.
Robot. Поехали!
Вертолет противника. У нас гости. Нужен транспорт. Вперед!
No.
All right, and by the way,
server crash?
If you say yes.
All right, I guess it's time for a 5-10 minute break. Alright.
So just stay one on the Supreme Court.
She think it's gonna
happen? As long as I keep my power. Okay, at least you're being more honest. But I don't really have the rest of it. So then you know one of the things they said last night? They said, you know, you should call your GOP senators, call the Republican senators, and tell them what's what. Are we really still doing that? Look, sometimes Wolfpack will call state legislators, but with constituents in their area, and they are much more responsive to their constituents because they have less constituents, right? Whereas the national legislators could care less about them. They have zero concern about them. This is Republican! Republican! Oh, got a lot of calls for voters. Oh, they must have had a good laugh over that. Over a good stiff cognac at the super spreader Rose Garden confirmation event that they had, right? So they're like, oh, they have more voters calling you too because of the digital filibuster. If you came at it with a couple million bucks, then all of a sudden they're going to take your call, and then maybe they don't do that. Okay, but it is perfectly legal. Set up a super PAC. You do that all day long. By the way, that's another option. That's a sixth option. If there really was a magical mythical George Soros, he could have called up Republican senators and go, why don't I give you guys 2 million? What is it going to take? 5 million, 10 million apiece in your campaign coffers, and you don't propose. They probably would have taken it. That's all they care about is the money. We couldn't even bribe them. ExxonMobil bribes them all day long. In Geo Prison Group, bribes them all day long. All the drug companies bribe them all day long. Don't bribe anybody, legal or otherwise, but our guys are in the unilateral surrender business. So, you remember how I told you Murkowski was full of crap? She wanted to vote for Barrett, and she voted for Barrett. You want to know why? Hey, Zach Charlie, thank you for the super chat. You want to know why? Because she realized, oh, there's no consequence. She was worried that the Democrats were going to hold her accountable, and if she was so wildly hypocritical in delaying Garland, helping the Republicans delay Garland for a year, and then confirm Barrett a week before the election, that she might have to pay a political price for that because she's posing as a moderate Republican. And then she looked around and she's like, oh, right, I forgot. These guys suck at all. I'm not going to have to pay any kind of price at all. There's going to be no consequence. So, yeah, then I'll vote for her. Weekly Schumer and Durbin. I wonder if she spit on him on the way to voting yes. Look at these guys. They did nothing. I thought they were going to do something. They did nothing. Chris Hollins, thank you for joining up as a member. I got more where that came from. Now, last depressing fact. You want to know what percentage of the federal judiciary Donald Trump, any given president, can't fill that much because. Associate Trump, he's not even 2 terms, he's just been 4 years, and obviously every president does it, so a ton of the judiciary is left over from Reagan, Clinton, Bush, the other Bush, Obama, etc. So if they got 10% of the judiciary, that'd be a really nice number. Okay. Trump has filled 1/3 of the federal judiciary. How did he do that in 4 years? Well, here's how they did it. Mitch McConnell started blocking all judges, not just the Supreme Court justices, all judges, with almost 2 years left in Obama's term. He grinded to a halt throughout the entire 8 years, but as they got closer to the election, 2 years out, 1 year out, he just slammed on the brakes. And so all these positions, they create a logjam. Obama should have filled all those seats. But Schumer and Durbin and honestly Obama and Biden, their response to Mitch McConnell's tactics were, I don't know what to do. What am I? A politician? What am I? A legislator? I don't know. Give me money. They let McConnell roll them. And so when Trump came in, now did the Democrats